Kate, the Broadway musical Dreamgirls has become a global hit with audiences loving the story about a young female singing trio, and the music from the show still sends tingles down your spine like this song. That is extraordinary range, but it was actually Jennifer Holliday who first sang "And I Am Telling You I'm Not Going" in the Broadway production back in 1981, and it has endured ever since. And we're so lucky to have this superstar on our couch. Please welcome Grammy winner and soul sister Jennifer Holliday.
Thank you so much.
Now, you were just 21 years old when you auditioned for Dreamgirls.
Well, actually, I was 21 when we opened on Broadway. My very first show on Broadway was Your Arms to Strike to Bass with God, and then I was on already there when they were working on the workshop of Dreamgirls.
Wow.
And so I did Dreamgirls as a workshop for 2 years, then we opened on Broadway, so 19, and then we opened at 21.
When you were rehearsing it and singing the songs, did you think, this is something really special? Did you know? Did you get that feeling?
No, I didn't know, because theater, and I don't know if it's the same way here, you really do it for the love. Mm-hmm. You don't really get paid a lot of money. Back then, there wasn't a lot of fanfare like there is today because of social media. And you did it for the love. So we actually gave our all, contributed, you know, developed our characters, just knowing that we had something good, not knowing it would last 38 years ago.
Amazing.
38 years ago. No way that we could have known. And we just wanted it to be good as we could make it, and something that was innovative and new.
When you create a role like that, which you did, and then it goes on to be made into a feature film down the track, is part of you disappointed that you don't get to take the role onto film, which is
part
which
of you is
happened.
Very disappointed. Some people are gonna lie and say no. A lot of you is very disappointed. Okay.
But it happened. 95%.
Thank you.
It happened to. So you're in great company. You're in the company of people like Julie Andrews.
Yes.
And that sort of thing. But, you know, you own that song.
Yes. I you know, was disappointed, but I understood the dynamic of it, you know. And as we grow, I mean, I'm almost 60 years old now.
You are not.
Yes,
this I am.
You look amazeballs.
Thank you. You know, well, for though I know they're looking at that film and looking at me, but I don't know how you say pounds here, but 200 pounds since Dreamgirls.
I've lost.
So I don't know what kilos are. I was one of the first people to have a gastric bypass.
Wow.
So I had that on my 30th birthday.
That's 30 years ago. That was pretty great.
We might just bring up those pictures again. Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah. And at that point, I had... that was just at the beginning of Dreamgirls, but I gained another 100 pounds while I was in Dreamgirls as well.
Wow.
So I kept gaining.
Was that eating bad late night snacks at Sardi's?
No, that was depression.
Was it?
That was depression. Oh. I was a young star and not knowing how to cope with it, doing 8 shows a week, only one day off, and really had no time to be with my friends. And it wasn't like now where you can text people and do email and all kind of things. Yeah, you can keep in touch. But back then it was like, I have to rest my voice on Monday, and then the rest you're doing a week. So it was very hard to, you know, have friendships and relationships, and so food became my best friend.
Wow.
And I kept gaining weight and gaining weight, and it was just out of control. And so on my 30th birthday, I actually tried to commit suicide.
Oh my gosh.
Because I lost my record deal because they said I was too big and overweight, and I didn't know how I was gonna get my career. I lost lost everything. And so then they said, well, there's this surgery. If you want to try it, it's experimental. Maybe you could lose weight and help. So I did, and then things began to pick up again.
Wow.
That surgery was really rare.
Your self-belief picked up again? That what really happened, your confidence?
Well, not so much my confidence came out, because what you find out, most people, is that it's more than weight. So I lost a lot of weight, and I still had excess baggage because I still had issues in my head. So you have to really find out what's going on inside of you. Why was I lonely? Why were I as unable to move forward? So I had to learn a lot in the years.
That surgery would have been incredibly rare back then, wouldn't
it? Very rare.
Were you worried about what it could do? Because, of course, you know, singing is all about your chest cavity, your diaphragm. Yeah. Were you worried that it might change your voice, or that something else might
happen? I wasn't worried that I changed my voice. I just knew that the reason why I had got fired and lost my job and my career and stuff, because they said I was overweight. And I didn't know how I was going to lose it, so I needed to take a chance. And so, thank God I'm still here.
But with a voice like yours, should that have mattered?
Well, unfortunately, it still matters today. Isn't that sad? That you can have talent, you can be amazing, and it's still not enough.
Still gonna be thin.
People have to make up stories about their lives in order to get attention on the media.
Can I mean, ask that's just, you, with your voice, did you do gospel singing when you were little?
Yes, as most soul singers, we grew up in the Baptist Church Choir, and that's where I was discovered, singing in the Pleasant Grove Baptist Church Choir in Houston, Texas.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
Now, we've got a little clip of you surprising Whoopi Goldberg recently on The View. Can we show this?
Okay.
Take a look.
Thank you.
That was amazing.
That was for her birthday, and what they were doing was all of the hosts were actually being in like an American Idol.
Got it.
And so they were singing their favorite songs. So Whoopi actually cannot sing at all a note. So she started off lip singing to me, and then I came in to surprise her singing for real.
Didn't do anything to hurt your voice, the weight loss. Nothing.
Also, just so you know, Jennifer, my birthday is June 23rd.
And September 6th, I'm going in.
Okay, all right. We have to send you a message, a videogram for your birthday.
Awesome.
Have to do that.
That voice is a gift
from
God or whatever you believe in. It is an absolute gift. And if you live in Australia, live in Sydney especially, you can actually hear Jennifer Holliday perform for the very first time in Australia at the Sydney Cabaret in July. Visit sydneycabaretfest.com to grab your tickets from tomorrow onwards.
You're going to love
it. And actually, I have two shows at Town Hall.
Oh,
so I have two nights. So I'll be there. I'll be there with my band. Are you going back
to our show?
I hope so.
And you're going to wear these fantastic Ugg boots. Get a load of these.
Shoe cam. Special Uggs. We love Uggs in America. They are worn during the summertime. Every time, not for comfort, but for fashion. And I'm glad to let you know, I passed by a couple of Ugg stores who do not have these, baby. They are real and special ordered.
That's the ultimate special Diva Ugg. Jennifer Holliday, everyone.
Yeah.